Hi, my name is Helena, and I'm a public health scientist. This means I study how diseases spread in populations. What I love about public health is that it brings together my love for computer science and data to make an impact on people in a positive way. Scientists use the power of computer science all the time. We use computer simulations to understand the spread of new viruses. A simulation is a computer model of a process or a system. Simulations are a great way to learn things that can be hard to observe in the real world. They help scientists solve problems and test new ideas safely and efficiently. This graph represents the amount of people infected. In this case, we want to flatten the curve. Flattening the curve means that we slow the rate of people getting sick. That buys health professionals more time to get people vaccinated and to save more lives. We also want to help scientists and doctors get relevant data as they collaborate to create vaccines and work on new treatments. In today's lesson, we'll visit a fictional place called Monster Town, where a virus outbreak is about to happen. We'll be using computer science to understand how quickly a virus can spread and what can be done to slow it down so that all the monsters can get healthy again. We'll ask the questions: how quickly will the virus spread? What can we and Dr. Monster do to combat and contain the virus? You'll experiment with a few different interventions, like masks, crowds, and vaccines. You might already know the answers, but take a closer look. Run your simulation multiple times. What do you notice?